Hello children, today we are going to discuss about soil. First we are going to discuss about composition. What is the soil composed of? Children, soil is made up of two main components. First, mineral particles. And second, humus. Tiny bits of mineral particle which come from the larger rocks. These minerals include salts of iron, calcium, potassium, magnesium, phosphorus, etc. So these minerals, they come from the rocks. Many of these minerals are needed by plants for their growth. Second part is humus. The other component is humus, which is dark brown in color and consists of decaying remains of plants and animals. A variety of dead and decaying organisms contribute to the formation of humus. Okay children, apart from this, these two things, soil also contains water, air and living organisms. What do you think? Water, air and living things. Living things means a small creature. Soil is home of many small creatures. Water and air are needed for soil organism to survive and for dead and decaying matter to be converted to humus. Children, all you know, humus makes the soil fertile by providing organic nutrients. It also provides food to earthworm and other other animals living in the soil, and also it improves the texture of the soil and prevents mineral being washed away by water. Now children, so many animals, they live in the soil, like millipedes, centipedes, so many ants, variety of ants, fungi, bacteria and also earthworm. Many of them play very active part in maintaining the fertility of soil. And children, one more thing I would like to tell you, earthworm, very important. We also call earthworms farmer's friend. They improve the texture of soil by burrowing into the soil. They make it loose, like farmers, they loosen the soil before sowing the seeds and all. Same manner, they also, for burrowing, they make the soil loose and allowing the air to enter into it and water to drain from it. They also form channels in the soil for roots to spread through. So in short, we can say they make the soil loose, like farmers, they till the soil, same manner they do. And children, bacteria and fungi living in the soil, they help in decaying plants and animals, and they help in forming humus. Okay, like bacteria and fungi, you know, saprophytes, they are there in the soil and they help in the formation of humus. Some bacteria convert nitrogen of the air, like rhizobium, very important bacteria. It is found in, it is there in the soil. It converts nitrogen present into the air into the usable form, and we call this process fixing of nitrogen. Now children, our next topic is formation of soil. Children, in the beginning, the earth was rocky. Almost rocks were everywhere. Okay, no soil was there. How this soil is formed, we are going to discuss there. What do we call it? This process, we call it weathering. Soil was not present on the earth at the time of its formation. Only rocks were there in the beginning. Long ago, the ground was mostly solid rock. Over millions of years, this rock got partially changed into soil by process. What do we call that process? Weathering. Weathering means breaking of rock and formation of soil. Weathering is the breaking down of huge pieces of rocks into smaller pieces by the action of natural forces. Natural forces, what are those natural forces? Like water, natural forces, water, glaciers, wind. Water, glaciers, wind, roots of plants and roots of plants. So these are the natural forces which help in the formation of formation of soil. And what do we call this process? Weathering. Okay. So we are going to discuss one by one these agents of weathering. First agent is water. What is the role of water? The role of water in weathering of rocks is particularly important. Rain water enters crevices of rock. This is rock. Sometimes you have seen crevices are formed. Crevices means cracks. Okay? And crevices are formed. In winter, as this water freezes, crevices are there and rain took place, and what happened? This crevice is filled with water. Okay. And in winter, this water is going to freeze and turn into ice. Okay. Water freezes and this water expands. This water expands. This expansion breaks the rock into smaller pieces. This process keeps on taking place, and what happened? This will make the rock what? Weak. And rock will break. The broken, and after breaking of rock, what will happen? Rock will break. Okay. The broken pieces roll down by the force of flowing water. Up, you know, rivers and all, they are coming down from the mountains and all. So these broken pieces, they roll down by the force of flowing water or wind. As they collide against the ground, and again they break down further into small fragments. Okay. Finally, they get converted into very fine particle and mix with humus. We have seen near the banks of river, these fine particles, big pieces, boulders, you have seen. Okay, roots of tree, up they turn into fine pieces. Roots of trees growing through rocks. Another way I am going to tell you that roots of plants. First water, I told you, now roots of plants. What happened, children? In the beginning, what happened? Very small plants like mosses and all, they grow on the rocks. Okay, later on, due to they produce acid and all, they make a very thin layer of soil, powdery soil. Later on, big plants, they grow. Like herbs, they grow. And they also turn the rock into fine powder, the roots of these plants. So roots of trees growing through rocks exert great pressure on the rocks. These roots, they exert great pressure on the rocks. This causes cracks in the rocks. When they exert pressure, the formation of crack takes place, leading to weathering. Same manner, the pieces, they are going to break from the main rock and they fall down. Large variation in day and night temperature, for example. Next is variation in the temperature. Large variation in day and night temperature in northern India also cause weathering. Like in northern India, during the day it is hot, and what happened? The minerals present in these rocks, they also expand due to heat of the sun. Okay, the rocks expand during the day and contract at night. This continuous expansion and contraction, okay, this constant expansion and contraction weakens the rock and they crack and crumble. Next is, in hot and humid climate, high temperature causes chemical weathering. to occur, the mineral in the rock react with oxygen. The mineral are present, they react with oxygen and they form oxides. Such oxidized rocks, they become weak, they crumble and they form soil. So weathering of rocks is a slow process. It takes hundreds of years to produce a few centimeters of soil. Now children, we are going to discuss soil profile. Soil profile, children, when you must have seen when the people they dig for the dig the soil for the foundation of a building, you must have noticed that soil changes color as one goes deeper. The size of the bits of rock changes too. The main layers of soil are topsoil, subsoil and parent rock. We have divided this in three parts: topsoil, or we call that horizon A, subsoil horizon B, and horizon C is parent rock. I am showing you here. Okay, this is the rock, main rock from which this part is made. Okay, here the big pieces are present and we call it bedrock. Impervious. This is impervious, it does not allow water to go down. Here small fragments are lying there. And this is what horizon C. Bedrock is what horizon C. Then we have subsoil. We have subsoil or horizon B. Upper soil is, we also call it topsoil. We also call it topsoil, horizon A. Okay, so first we are going to discuss about horizon A. In this layer, humus and the smallest particle of rock form the upper layer of soil. Very fine particles are there, and in this layer, plants they grow. Okay. And the particles of soil, they are small. The presence of humus gives it a dark color. Because of the humus, it becomes dark. Okay. It is the layer containing the most nutrient for the plant. It contains nutrients because of humus, and plants grow well in this. The root of most plants are confined to this layer. Humus makes this layer porous and fertile. Because of humus, this layer is porous, means it water can percolate, water can go down, and also it is fertile just because of humus. Now come to the subsoil or B horizon. This is the layer below the topsoil. Subsoil does not have much humus. Okay, very little humus. Therefore, lighter in color. The color is light. The color is light. Okay, because humus is not there. Here humus is there, that is why it is dark. It is made up of mostly of rock beds and some nutrients such as soluble minerals which comes down, and also oxides of iron. Rainwater collects in this layer. Now come to the parent rock or sea horizon. Below the subsoil is the parent rock or sea horizon. Okay. Which consists of small pieces of rocks. You are seeing here small pieces of rocks with cracks and crevices. Here, like some cracks are there, small pieces are there, big pieces are there also. They have cracks also and crevices. The particles of rocks found in soil come from weathered rock, means like these pieces we are seeing here, they are what? Weathered rock. Below this, there is a solid rock, we call this bed. This is what? Bedrock. As in the beginning I told you, it is non-porous. Okay, non-porous means water cannot go down. When rain takes place, water gets collected over here. Rainwater gathers here and form the water table. Now, children, our next topic is types of soil. We have divided the soil into three parts: clay soil, sandy soil, and loamy soil. We have divided according to the particle of the size particle of the soil. Children, clay is very small in size. Its size is the diameter of the particle is 0.002 millimeter. Okay. This is the size of the particle, diameter of the particle of clay. And silt, or the silt, here I am writing down silt. Okay. Silt, the size is larger than the clay. Larger than the clay. The size is 0.002 to 0.2 millimeter in diameter. Okay, we find it near the banks of the river. Sand, it has large size particle. And children, this silt, it is not so smooth. This is very smooth. The clay particle, first we are going to discuss about particle. Clay particle, they are very smooth because they are very small. And they are not very smooth, the size becomes larger now. It can be found in a river bed, like near Ganges we can find this. Sand has the largest sized particles. Okay. Like larger than 0.2 millimeter sand. Okay, they are coarse in touch. When you must have seen at construction site, these sands, when you touch, they are coarse in touch. Coarse means rough. In addition to these topsoil, also we have small stones like things. We call that gravel. What do we call that? Gravel. Okay, so these the topsoil in a particular geographical area may contain only one kind of rock particles or a mixture of two or three types. Children, now on the basis of this, we have divided the soil. I am going to tell you about those type of soil. First is sandy. As I told you, particles are big. Sandy soil, particles are big. It has lot of sand in it and very little silt and clay. In sandy soil, what is the composition? More sand, very little clay and silt. Very little. Okay. It can hold, because the particles are big, so it can hold air. Okay. This soil is air. Hold air but cannot hold much water. Water drains quickly through large spaces between the sand particles. Now next is clay soil. All you know, the particles are very small of clay. More clay is there and less sand and silt. Which most contain clay? Water drains through this type of soil very little, because the particles are very small and they are tightly packed. This type of soil is not able to trap enough air because space is not there for the roots of plants. So it is not good for plants. It is used for making pots and all. The best topsoil for growth is loam. Okay, loam. Loam is a mixture of sand, silt, and clay. This is also, but here these are in very small quantity. And in this addition of these three, what fourth thing is there? Humus. What else is there? Humus. Okay. It has the right, it hold right amount of water and also air. It can trap air. It also has adequate spaces between the soil particle to trap required by the roots of plants. So this is best kind of soil to grow plant. Okay. Now one activity I am going to discuss. This activity is going to tell to find out the proportion of different solid components in garden soil. What we will do? We will dig up a handful of garden soil and place it in a beaker. And I add about 500 ml of water and shake the beaker off for a little while. Now allow the soil to settle down. What we will notice, just see first, see the diagram. This is beaker. We have taken soil and added water and allowed to settle down. We will find different layers have been formed. First, we will find the big pieces are there and we call that gravel. What are these gravels? Because they are heavy, they settle down. And then the less heavier, that is sand. Second layer we will find is of sand. Less heavier than gravel, but heavier than silt. Then we have the layer of silt. According to the size of particles, as I told you, clay is very fine. This is clay. This is clay. Very fine particle. So, heaviest one, gravel here, then sand. After that, we will find silt and then clay. Okay. And clay is suspended in the water, also some particle, and also here we will find humus, dead remains of plants, and because they are very light, so they float on water. Okay, this is what humus. So, the particles of different size in the soil separate out to form different layers in the beaker. At the bottom will be a layer of gravel which has the heaviest particle. Above this will be a layer of sand and then a layer of silt. The top layer consists of clay. The humus being lighter than water floats on water. Okay, children. So, that's all. Thank you.